Hello everyone, welcome back. This is me, Jasneet Kaur. If you are a student of home science subject or you are working in the field of home science, then don't forget to do thumbs up, subscribe my channel and share it with your family and friends. To get notifications of my next uploads, don't forget to hit the bell icon as well. Now let's talk about what this video is all about. Today we will cover chapter 16 of NCERT book of class 12. To understand it thoroughly, make sure you watch this video till the end. So let's begin with the introduction first. Human resource management or HRM is considered pillar of any organization. Why is that so? You will understand it by the end of the video in detail. Precisely if I say, then it is called so because it focuses on the recruitment, management, providing guidance and direction to the people working in an organization. The HR department ensures that the necessary need of employees must be fulfilled and they remain productive in an organization. Let's understand how these things work out. Firstly, let's go through the definition of human resource management or HRM. It says the HRM is that part of the management which develops and manages the employees of any organization considering their resourcefulness or usefulness in terms of their knowledge, skills, creative abilities, talents, aptitudes, and potentialities for effective contribution to the organizational growth. You can also refer to the definition given by Gary Deslow. Understand what he says. Resource management is the process of acquiring, training, promoting, giving salaries, and understanding employees' relation with employer and with employees. Also, their health, safety, and their fair concerns. All organizations are largely dependent on the quality of its manpower for their profitability and performance. Let's look at closely the role and responsibility of professionals in the field of HRM. HRM focuses on tackling employees' issues so that their productivity can be enhanced and organizations can get better result in terms of profits. The other function HRM has is multifunctional approach. So it focuses on all those aspects which help an employee to work better, like training, leadership roles, motivation, increment in salaries, induction. Induction is introduction of new employees to the organization's working pattern, rules and regulations, etc. The other function which we talk about is HRM also includes human resource development. HRD is a process of increasing knowledge, skills, and capacities of the employees in an organization. For more clarity, you can see this image. The arrow in the left bottom indicates that every individual begins from selection and recruitment and goes further step by step. After understanding the kind of work which is being done in HRM, let's discuss what are the functions of HRM professionals, or we can say role of people working in HR department. Majorly, we have recruitment and staffing, training and development, retention and redressal. Let's discuss each in detail. Beginning with recruitment and staffing. Before starting with the subparts, I would like to add, whenever any organization is set up, it is essential to have rough estimate of the number of people, their age, role, skills, experience, gender, capabilities, etc. required at workplace. Hence, manpower planning, also known as human resource planning, consists of putting right number of people, right kind of people at the right place at right time and doing the right things. Before recruitment, it is important to understand the concept of job analysis. Job analysis can be done through two ways. First, job description. In this, the task and responsibilities related to the job are clearly mentioned in the job posting. Second, whereas job specification, if I say, emphasize on the skill sets or capabilities one should possess. This can be understood better with this example. The image on the left side is the example of job description, as roles and responsibilities are clearly mentioned, whereas the image on the right side is perfect example of job specification, as it is clearly mentioned which subject teacher they are looking for. Moving on to the second sub-point of recruitment and staffing, that is selection and recruitment of workforce. Now, once the advertisement is posted either in newspaper or on flyers or on any online job portals, the people who are looking for job, their profiles will start pouring in. Recruitment is the process of selecting or hiring the best candidate for the job among enormous applicants. By arranging their interviews or by conducting written tests, group discussions, as well as by verifying their required documents and references. The process of selection can differ from organization to organization. There are a lot of terms used as synonym to recruitment like talent acquisition, headhunting, or talent hiring. Let's move to second major function of HRM professionals, that is training and development. It is the subsystem of an organization which focuses on the improvement of the performance of individuals and groups. It focuses on sharpening skills, concepts, change in attitudes, and gaining more knowledge to enhance the performance of the employees. A good training always helps employees to excel in their skills and knowledge, which eventually helps an organization to grow. Let's discuss more about the need or benefits of training. If employees will be well trained, naturally productivity will be more. Development of skills like time management, optimum utilization of resources, promoting teamwork improves quality and safety to increase business and build company's image. These all are would be the benefit of training and development. General techniques which are used to provide training and development are lecture by specialists, group discussions, briefing by seniors, role plays, video or computer teaching activities, case studies or by observation, quizzes, etc. Let's move to third subtopic of training and development, that is motivation and mentoring. Both things boost morale of employees and constant guidance are very important for high performance. Moving ahead, let's discuss the third function of HRM professionals, that is retention and redressal. Retention means control and redressal means remedy. Employee retention means controlling the resignation of employees. It refers to the various policies and practices which let the employees stick to an organization for a longer period of time. While talking about redressal, it is important to understand the meaning of the term grievances. Grievances means any type of dissatisfaction or discontentment which employee is experiencing at workplace. Due to any reason like unfair practices, poor working conditions, violation of company's rules and regulations, violation of labor laws, etc. Employee redressal means handling issues of employees which they have experienced at workplace due to any reason. The other function of HRM is acting mediator between employees and employers, maintaining employees' behavior and disciplines, ensuring safety of employees at workplace, handling issues of sexual harassment, theft, and misbehavior, paying employees their increment, reward and recognition, and sustaining high-performance employees. There are more functions which HRM professionals play, like giving retirement benefits, medical benefits to the employees of the organizations, vacations or leaves to the employees, etc. For more information, you can refer to your NCERT book page number 302. The same functions are further elaborated through the charts for better clarity. Students, let's have a quick look to what we have understood from today's video. We have covered introduction to HRM, meaning of HRM, role of HRM, and functions of HRM professionals. I hope you all have understood concept clearly. Further, I have mentioned few questions which you all have to do it in your notebooks on the basis of the understanding of the topics covered. I will see you soon with the second part of this chapter. Till then, bye-bye and take care.